Rate gowns don't come cheap.
It's 11.
This is $12,000.
It's a down payment on a house.
And even brides with big bank accounts can have a hard time finding the perfect wedding dress.
I hate that one. I hate it.
For us, a big budget usually means $10,000 or more. And the bigger the budget, the louder the opinions.
My name is Leah Kahn, and my fiance's name is Rafe Bonvillian. We met at Yale. I was a senior. He was a junior.
Tell me about price point.
I think around 10.
Dad got the look immediately.
I gave a range 5 to 10, but yeah, if 10's, yeah.
So he says 5 because he knows we'll double it, whereas if he said 10, we would try to push it to like 15.
Leah doesn't have any particular style in mind, but her 15-year-old sister Dana knows what sort of expensive gown she wants.
Something with texture and a little bit of bling. I love this one. Isn't this gorgeous?
I think this one is just too simple. Just doesn't look good on her.
I thought
her butt looked really big.
I thought it made her look skinny.
Yeah, maybe.
Hey.
I love this. Dee, what do you think? Dee, what's the matter?
I could tell that Dana did not like this dress. This looks cheap.
No bride spending $10,000 wants to have any doubts about her dress. Little sis could derail this whole appointment.
Let me remind you, it's gonna be her wedding.
Despite the reminder, Dana goes hunting for an expensive gown she would wear.
This one's kind of cool. I think she should try on this one. Oh my gosh. It's so amazing. I love this. It's my favorite. It's what I pictured her in.
Leah's sister loves this dress, and she does look gorgeous in it. But Leah needs to make her own decision.
It's gorgeous.
Are we saying yes to this dress?
Dad?
The other one to say yes.
Is this your dress?
Yes.
But after coming down off the pedestal, Leah begins to realize she may have gotten swept up by her sister's pushy opinions. Now she's doubting her dress choice.
Oh my gosh.
This is my bride, Leah.
Hi.
Leah Shine.
Nice to meet you.
So your gown is $10,400.
Do you want to think about it? There's no additional charge for the covering the
Nope, there's
to
no. There's no additional charge for anything else.
Yep. Well, just I know. I just want to make sure, like that. I want to make sure Mom likes it. My presentation is. I felt like I was in someone else's dress. I just want like an hour to just think about it, because it's just a big decision, and I just felt a little rushed, and I just wanted to talk to my family. I think I just want to think about it over lunch, and then we'll call back. We can give the credit card over the phone.
Okay, perfect.
Because I just want to, like, have lunch and just, like, talk about it.
All right.
Yeah, Emma.
I know, Dee, it's her favorite dress.
I think the problem here is she wasn't listening to her voice, and she was really pleasing her little sister, Dana.
I think that if Leah listened to her inner voice, she would have gone in a much more productive appointment instead of changing her mind and not trusting her gut.
Leah's little sister, Dana, found the dress of her dreams, but Leah leaves empty-handed after a bridal salon nightmare.
Some big budget brides want to spend their money on a dress that pleases everyone. But when a wealthy bride wants a colorful collection of dresses, watch out, world.
My name's Michelle, and I'm the type of person that people meet and then don't forget.
Hoping to leave a lasting memory for her wedding guests, Michelle's purchased 2 gowns totaling $13,000, one in pink for the reception and white for her ceremony.
The fiancé paid for both of them. He is a perfect man. I really love him. I'm going to wear the white dress for the ceremonies. The first time he should see me is in the romantic, you know, the lovey-lovey one. And the party is the pink dress because it's nuts.
Okay.
Wow.
Wow.
If you've got a budget big enough for 2 dresses, you definitely want those 2 to stand apart from each other. And with one in white and the other in pink, Michelle's got the right idea.
But seeing the pricey $7,000 pink dress up close has Michelle worried she's strayed a little too far out of the box.
I know the pink dress is definitely a risk.
Did you expect it to be as pink as
it
is?
No, it came in pinker than I thought it would be.
Yeah. Michelle, it is absolutely you.
Yeah.
It really is fabulous.
Awesome.
Isn't it nuts?
It's so much fun.
What about the older folks?
I don't really care what they're gonna think.
Michelle is totally confident in who she is. And if you're spending $13,000 on two different dresses, you better feel confident.
No one else can pull this off. That's awesome. Two thumbs up.
A bride with a huge budget can get whatever she wants. But when Dad's got the checkbook, a bride's gotta work hard for that money.
My name is Liz. My fiance's name is Dan. He totally balances me out. He's made me really happy.
Liz already found her dream dress in a previous appointment, but with a hefty price tag of $10,000, she's going to need some help.
I'm a daddy's girl, so I really wanted him to come and see this dress and give me the okay and buy it.
Oh, hello. Oh, look at the back.
I can't stop smiling. I love this one.
What does everybody else think?
Not the reaction that I was looking for.
This is gonna come up.
We were hoping so.
Dad's not gonna drop $10,000 on a dress for his daughter if he thinks it's too sexy.
That's gonna be all covered.
Still, you're still gonna have some cleavage showing.
I mean, is it inevitable that you have a little bit? This is it. I'm saying yes.
This is certainly one way to convince Dad to pay up, but I wouldn't normally recommend this tactic to a bride looking for approval.
I like the dress.
Yes!
Yes!
I am very relieved that my dad loves the dress.
Our brides keep breaking the bank, and one bride is also breaking the rules set by her conservative relatives.
Hello, Kirsten?
Hi. Yes.
Hi, Kirsten.
Hi.
How are you?
My name is Kirsten Hughes. My fiance's name is Phil Daugherty. Phil is the perfect marriage of every guy I've ever gone out with. He's just the best.
So tell me what you would like to spend.
8 to 10. But if I find something over, you know, it's workable.
Kirsten's mom and aunt are footing the big bill, but with one caveat.
I have told Kirsten I will not buy you a corset dress.
My mother does not like the corset dresses because they're a little trashy. I just want to try one on. That's it. That's all.
Per the bride's request, Debbie puts Kirsten into an expensive, blinged-out corset dress.
I know, I'm terrible. I love this dress. I think it's beautiful.
But Kirsten's mom and aunt don't love the corset.
It's a bit distasteful looking.
I don't care for that one if you don't mind.
No, you don't care for that.
No, I don't like it.
If you've got a big budget, you should be able to go for whatever you want. But remember, if someone else is paying, the choice isn't entirely up to you.
Undeterred, Kirsten's next pricey pick also has a corset.
Wow. That's cute. Oh, it laces up the back?
Yes.
Uh-oh.
What, is that good or bad?
It's fine for me.
Uh-oh, what?
I don't know.
Oh.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
What do you think?
I love this.
You like it?
I like it.
Yes, I'm going back on my word, but I have to say, I love it, and she couldn't have been lovelier.
Even though this dress has a corset, it's not as obvious because of all the beautiful detail. But that amount of detail will definitely increase the price.
So the price of this dress is $11,600. Doable?
Doable. Doable.
I didn't stay within my budget. Not a surprise, if you know me.
Do you think this is your dress?
Yes.